The Importance of Fanboys for Feminists, a title which we will revisit twice more before the end of this poem, for I am afraid far too many folks will not understand this the first time, and I do not mean to offend you with that statement, nor is it my intent to be unnecessarily obtuse, but I want to write this convoluted poem, or maybe it's not convoluted, I think it's kind of clever, yet I'm still worried people won't get it, so I'm sorry, I guess. You see, I haven't met many fanboy feminists, but I imagine some must exist, so I recently developed this fanboy feminist litmus test. Honestly, the test will work for any nerdy feminist, but for the purposes of this poem, I've chosen to focus on those of us most often centered in discussions of nerdiness. First, find a person familiar with the works of Joss Whedon. Second, ask them if they consider Joss Whedon to be a feminist. Now, before we move on, I'll admit that one of feminism's finest features is the fact that folks can self-identify, but the persistent insistence that Xander Harris is a registered trademark nice guy speaks louder than words. Plus, I don't know if you've heard, but Joss Whedon's recently expressed opinion on the term feminist seems to me to be at least a little bit absurd, but back to the test. Is Joss Whedon a feminist? If they just say yes, they're probably not a feminist. If they just say no, that's a little bit better, but let's be honest, you still don't know, because feminists rarely see things in such simple terms. What I mean to say is, feminists, for the most part, seem to prefer qualifying statements to simple, straightforward answers. Perhaps this test is a perfect example of this. I mean, I am a feminist, and I love Buffy far more than most, but Joss Whedon's feminism must be called into question, or at the very least qualified, but even that's beside the point, as this poem's on the importance of fanboys for feminists, and feminists are like the best metaphors. They're deeply invested in exploring multiple meanings, and fanboy feminists may be few and far between, but fanboys, like feminists or metaphors, can mean more than one thing. And if you ask me, fanboys can be a feminist's best friend. It all depends on your definition. The Oxford English Dictionary defines fanboys as male fans, especially those obsessed with comics, music, film, or science fiction. On the other hand, my 8th grade English teacher, Miss Roy, taught me that fanboys is an acronym for for and nor but or yet so, the coordinating conjunctions. Let me spell it out for y'all nice and slow. F. For, A, and, N, nor, B, but, O, or, Y, yet, S, so. Fanboys are the coordinating conjunctions, and boy, am I a fan of the coordinating conjunctions. I mean, I love holding ands for hours on end like some never-ending improv exercise. Yes, and, yes, and, yes, and, no. I do not condone the message of Sir Mix-a-Lot's Baby's Got Back, but, and this is a big but, I like big buts, and I cannot lie because I am a feminist, and I absolutely adore fanboys for and nor but or yet so for. The coordinating conjunctions allow me to go deeper in each statement I make, and make no mistake, I do not mean to suggest this is necessarily the best way to engage one's ideas, nor do I wish to put forth fanboys as an exhaustive list of conjunctions, because I wouldn't want to forget about the subordinate conjunctions like because, but this poem is already too long, or maybe it's the perfect length, yet I'm still worried it's convoluted, so I'll conclude it with this. The coordinating conjunctions are key to feminist discourse, thus the importance of fanboys for feminists.
Survived empires and invaders, known that you were a gift meant for gods. Honey, have you ever been wealthy?